Hello everyone, hope you are doing good. Welcome to SN Classroom. Today we are going to learn a simplified shaft alignment method using a simple brass strip. In process industries, there are equipment like stationary equipment and rotary equipment. In rotary equipment, motors are generally the drivers. Motors will run a pump or a compressor, a gearbox, blower and like rotating equipment. If the central line of motor and the central line of the driven equipment, if they are not aligned properly, they will produce vibration, undue vibrations. These vibrations are going to fail the bearing and then mechanical seal, and then they will lead to internal rubbing. So it is essential to align a motor central line in line with the driven equipment central line. Thereby you will be ensuring the reliability of the equipment. In an oil industry, say a refinery, there could be hundreds of pumps, if not in thousands. If the alignment is not proper and if the equipment fail, here one, there one, there could be many equipment failing and which will become a nightmare of maintenance and operation people. So, they need to be aligned, there is no doubt about that, everybody agrees that. When often we need to do alignment? There could be three occasions. Number one, during the erection of the equipment, erection and commissioning, there will be a need to align. The motor is new, the pump is new, they are from different manufacturing centers, companies. When they are put together, though it is been designed that central line has to meet in one line, due to many practical difficulties, they need not be in one line. We need to align that. Number two, many reasons are there to have a equipment failure. Motor bearing fails or mechanical seal of the pump fails. So it goes to workshop for a rebuild. Back to its position, the alignment would have got disturbed. The earlier established alignment would have got disturbed. That is number two. The third is, in a normal running pump, the vibration survey on a periodical interval says that the trend of the vibration is going up. That gives a hint that the equipment is not proper. To start with, you doubt the misalignment. There again, you are to check the alignment to ensure that they are in one line or not. Well, barring the third kind of alignment, which is called preventive maintenance check, for first two needs, you need to drop the spool piece of the equipment. Today, in all advanced designs, the pumps come with a spool piece. There is a special requirement for it. We will discuss in some other session why it is called for. So when the spool piece is, dropped, you have to check the alignment for the first two kinds. For the third one, you don't need to disturb the spool piece. With the spool piece there in its position, you can ensure the alignment. So the first one, during the first installation of the equipment, or after a maintenance, we need to check the alignment. When we are going to do alignment, which equipment we are going to align with the other? It's always preferable to align in the motor with the driven equipment. The driven equipment may be pump, compressor, blower, whatever it is. So the driver, why we prefer motor to be aligned? The reason is, motor is flexibly connected, whereas pump is rigidly connected. That means, motor has got a cable. Motor can be moved here and there easily. The pump has got suction and discharge line connected to that. So it's difficult to adjust the pump for adding the shim or shifting it one way or the other. So it is advisable, as a standard thumb rule, we align the motor to the driven equipment. Motor has got 4 foot. Unlike a tripod, motor doesn't necessarily touch its foundation plate, basement plate, without any gap. 3 might be touching its bed, and 1 may have a gap. This is called a soft foot. With this soft foot, we cannot align properly, and it is dangerous also. Now, let's say that one of it has got a soft foot. With that, if you are tightening it, it will warp the motor. With that condition, if you drive the motor, it might damage the bearing, or the rotor might touch the stator because of the warpage. So we have to identify whether all the 4 foot are uniformly touching its bed. Well, how to check that? First, after keeping the motor onto its position, just hand tighten the bolts. Just ensure that they are not loose or they are not tight enough. Just hand tighten the bolt. To check whether there is a gap under the foot, we can use a feeler gauge. Feeler gauge has got a lot of blades with different thickness. You will take one thin blade and insert this blade under the foot of all of them and see whether there is a gap existing or not. We are going to insert the feeler strips. I am inserting one by one and check whether there is a gap. There's no gap here, and there is no gap here either. Aha, here's gap. See, a huge gap. Let me find out how much it is. It goes snugly over here. How much is the thickness of this? two blades. Six tau plus five tau. That's 11 tau gap is existing here. So I need to fill this gap with 11 tau, 10 tau or 11 tau here. Fine. We found the soft foot. We are going to correct that. Having treated the soft foot by suitably adding the required shim, we will move on to the next step in alignment. Now we have to check how much misalignment is existing. It could be, the motor could be grossly up or down. To check that, using a dial gauge straight away is not recommended, because a huge up or down beyond the ability of the dial gauge to read might spoil this dial gauge. So I suggest a new way of testing it. I recommend a brass strip. A brass strip of 4 and 4/4 inch in length and about 1/2 inch or 12 millimeter in width, 0.2 millimeter thickness, with a hole at the in any one of the end. We will use this. This will minimize the time taking for checking the misalignment. Now, with the same gadget that's been used for dial gauge, instead of the dial gauge, we are going to use a strip like this. We will check where we are now actually. I'm going to fix this and then roll and see. This strip, which I suggested, is being fixed over here. Because it is brass, by hand or by a nose player, you can bend to a shape such that it just touches this rim of the hub. Okay. Now, it is touching the rim of the hub, that is in 12 o'clock position. I am rolling it down all the way to 6 o'clock position. See, now you see there is a gap, huge gap. We can use a feeler gauge to measure that. Even this is tedious. The best way to use a taper gauge, a very simple scale that's commercially available, a taper gauge. Using this, I am going to measure the gap. It's around 6 millimeter. You cannot and you need not measure this accurately. It is having a huge misalignment. That means the motor has to come up so that it will touch at the top, also touch at the bottom. Meaning that it is fairly centered. Let's see, it is 6 millimeter gap. We will add not 6 millimeter, we will add 3 millimeters. Why 3 millimeters? We will deal with that topic, with that discussion very, very detailed in the forthcoming session. Okay, we will add 3 millimeter shim uniformly at the 4 feet. We have added 3 millimeters for all the 4 feet. 3 millimeter shim for all the 4 feet. Uniformly the mortar has come up. Now let's watch what the readings are indicating. What's the gap is indicating. See that the gap is uniform on the top, also at the bottom. More or less 3 millimeters on the top and 3 millimeters in the bottom. Side also it is 3 millimeters, 2.8. Fine. Now it shows that the gap is uniform. Earlier the gap was 6 millimeter. We decided to add 3 millimeters. Now you are witnessing that it has uniformly distributed the gap. Let me check. Since it is brass, easy to work this way. Yes, I made it to touch at the top. See, it more or less touches the top, also the bottom. See, it is touching the top, also the bottom. We are only focusing the top and bottom. The horizontal alignment, you will see it later. Very good. Now addition of 3 millimeter shim has made the mortar to be roughly in concentric with this. Having achieved the rough alignment using the brass strip, very close to the target alignment. Here further, we can use a dial gauge or we can choose to use a laser gadget for making a perfect alignment. Hope this knowledge has imparted a good understanding in making a rough alignment using a brass strip. Thank you. This simple brass strip can do a mighty work in achieving your final target as close as possible. If you are new to our channel, please subscribe and click the bell icon. If you like this video and want more videos like this, give a thumbs up and leave your comment below.